Hello friends, welcome once again to the BISP Solutions. My name is Sandeep Singh. Today I would like to give you the overview about the intercompany elimination within the FCCS application. So what are the requirements that you are required to do within the application for eliminating the intercompany number? And if there is any difference between the intercompany transaction, the same should get stored in the plug account that you are required to associate with the intercompany account. Because while preparing the consolidated financial statement, you are required to eliminate all such intercompany transactions that took place between the parent and the subsidiaries or among the subsidiaries. All such elimination you will see at the consolidated entity level, because elimination takes place at the common parent within the FCCS application. For that purpose, I have created a scenario, and on the basis of which we are going to input our number within the application, and we will be going to see the numbers coming at the consolidated entity level. So you can see that we do have the two entities numbers, that is legal entity A and legal entity B. Legal entity A had the receivable of 60,000 from legal entity B, and they had made the sale to legal entity B by 60,000. The cost of goods sold for selling the transaction to B Limited is 50,000. Their cost of goods sold is 50,000, and they had credited the inventory by 50,000. So in the book of A Limited, it will report within the income statement, it will report their sales of 60,000 and the cost of goods sold is 50,000. So their net income will be 10,000. And in the balance sheet, they will display the receivable. They do have the receivable of 60,000. In the books of B Limited, it is showing that they had received the inventory from the A Limited. So they had debited the inventory by 60,000, and at the same time they had shown the intercompany payable, that is 60,000, to A Limited. Now the B Limited had sold those inventory to the third party, so they had recorded the transaction by account receivable. They had sold the same inventory by 80,000, so they had shown the account receivable 80,000, and they had credited their revenue by 80,000. Their trade cost of goods sold is 60,000, and they had credited the inventory by 60,000. So on their income statement in the B Limited, the sales reported is 80,000. Their cost of goods sold is 60,000, and they are reporting the margin of 20,000. And in the balance sheet, in the account receivable, they will report this figure of 80,000 that they had sold to the outsiders. Now on the consolidated financial statement, you are required to eliminate all such intercompany transactions. So on the consolidated financial statement, the number should come like this. The sale made to the outsider should only come to the consolidated financial statement. Therefore, the sales figure is 80,000. The cost of goods sold is the original cost of goods sold. It does not include any kind of intercompany profit. So you are seeing the cost of goods sold of number, the inventory number, that is the inventory number of A Limited, 50,000. Now on the, therefore the margin coming is 30,000. We have reduced the cost of goods sold from the sales, so we are getting the net income number 30,000. And on the and in the balance sheet, they will report 80,000 as an account receivable from the that they had sold to the outsider. So all the intercompany transaction that took place between the A and B Limited, it should eliminate. And you can see that on the elimination, it will be the transaction will appear in this manner, that they had the intercompany account payable earlier. We we have the account payable in the credit, but in the elimination it will goes into the reversal. So intercompany account payable here it is debiting, and the intercompany account receivable is 60,000. In the books of A Limited it is a debit. In the similar manner, the intercompany sales it is credited on the elimination. You will see that this amount gets debited. So the intercompany sales 60,000, intercompany cost of goods sold is credited, and any difference between the intercompany account it will store into the plug account. So therefore we do have the difference between the intercompany sales and intercompany cost of goods sold, so the difference will store into the plug account, and that plug account is intercompany markup. So now I will show you that how I have inputted those number within the application. So before inputting the number into application, what are the requirements that you are required to do within the application to perform the intercompany elimination within the application? So first you are required to create your entities within the application, and those entities you should define those entity as an intercompany entity. So within the dimension, if I would like to give you the how I have created the entity within the entity dimension. So under the total geography, I have created my consolidated entity AB Limited. Under this, I have added two children, that is A Limited and B Limited. And now if I go into the property of A Limited, you will see that I have defined this A Limited as an intercompany entity. So go within the attribute tab. You have the option of defining those entity as an intercompany entity. You can assign this if this is your intercompany entity, you can assign those entity as an intercompany entities. For the intercompany elimination, it is essential that you define your entities as an intercompany entities. So this is the primary requirement of intercompany elimination. Thereafter, go into the account dimension, and it is a requirement that all the intercompany account, you should define all your accounts, those accounts which are your intercompany account, you are required to define those account as an intercompany account within the application. So I have defined those accounts into application as an intercompany account. So I would like to give you the how I have defined those account as an intercompany account. So under the account receivable, you will see that I have created this account as an intercompany receivable. And if I am going into the property of this intercompany account, you will see that within the attribute, you will find that I have define those account as an intercompany account. This account is my intercompany account, and this account you are required to associate with your plug account. So I have associated this intercompany account with my plug account, that is intercompany receivable payable difference. So in this manner, you are required to associate your intercompany account. For that purpose, you are required, first you are required to prepare your intercompany plug account. So this is my plug account, intercompany receivable payable. Go into the properties, assign the plug account that this account is my plug account. So you do have the option of defining those account as an intercompany account, and if this account is your plug account, you need to tell your application that yes, this is my plug account. So in this way you are required to create your plug account. So I have defined those my intercompany account within the application, and I have created my my plug account within the application, and now I will be going to input the number as per the scenario we have created. So for that purpose, I have entered those numbers through the Smart View. So you can see that we do have the intercompany account receivable and intercompany sale in the book of A Limited. So this amount we need to enter against the intercompany partner. Therefore, you can see that we do have A Limited, and we are inputting those number against intercompany partner, that is B Limited. So now you can see that we do have intercompany account receivable, that is 60,000. So I have entered 60,000 within the application. Now coming on to the intercompany sales, so I have inputted those number as a intercompany sales, that is 60,000. Now intercompany cost of goods sold, I have inputted the number 50,000 against intercompany cost of goods sold. In inventory number is no, we have not defined this inventory as an intercompany account, so we are required to enter inventory amount without intercompany partner. So you can see that our inventory is crediting, therefore I have inputted those number with the negative, assuming that we do have the inventory and in the month of November, and we have sold those inventory in the month of December. So I have inputted those number into negative. So in the similar manner, you are required to enter your number for B Limited. So the inventory for B Limited is 60,000, but you are seeing here that I have not inputted any number here on the B Limited, because the inventory received by the B Limited had been sold to the outsider 60,000. So here the inventory is debiting and here the inventory is crediting, so the net result will be zero. So therefore I have not inputted any number against the inventory. The intercompany account payable, I have inputted those number against intercompany account payable, that is 60,000. So you can see that we do have 60,000 on the intercompany payable. In the similar manner, account receivable and operational sale, those numbers we need to enter without intercompany partner. So I have entered those number 80,000 in the account receivable, and my operational sale is 80,000, and the trade cost of goods sold is 60,000. So I have inputted against operational cost 60,000. So in this way, I have inputted those number into the application. Now we will check the result within the application, that how those numbers are coming. So now going into my income statement. So you can see that we do have the number of A Limited, B Limited, and AB Limited. In the A Limited, you are seeing the profit, that is 10,000. So you are finding on the A Limited, our operating income is 10,000. On the B Limited, our B Limited had an operating income of 20,000. So you are finding, and on the consolidated entity level, our margin is 30,000. So you are seeing that on the consolidated entity, our income is coming 30,000. Now going into the sales, we have recorded the sales, we have inputted the sales number in the books of A Limited is 60,000, and in the books of B Limited, both those numbers gets consolidated at the consolidated entity level. The elimination took place at the consolidated entity level, therefore the net sales amount is coming 80,000. In the similar manner, for the cost of sales, you can see that the inputted number is 110,000. We have the cost of sales of 50,000, so our cost of sales is 60,000. And you are finding that we, because the intercompany numbers, any difference between the intercompany number is get stored in the plug account. This is our plug account that we have created within the application. So any difference between the intercompany in this, you can see that we do have the intercompany sales against which intercompany cost of goods sold, but the remaining number, the remaining adjustment amount get stored into your plug account. So this is the plug account that the system is calculating. So here you are finding the 10,000 number. So on the consolidated entity level, you are finding your net income of 30,000 as per your functional calculated number. Now, coming on to the balance sheet, you can see that on the balance sheet, we do have the account receivable of 60,000 in the book of A Limited. In the book of B Limited, the account receivable amount is 80,000. And in the books of AB Limited, the account receivable amount is 80,000. So, and on the total liability and equity, our total liability is 50,000, what we have inputted in the month of November, and on the, this is the net profit that was earned in the month of December. So our total liability and equity amount is also 80,000. So on the balance sheet, your asset is exactly matches with the total liability and equity. So this is coming, the numbers are coming perfectly fine. So in this session, I have given you the overview that how, what configuration you are required to do within the application for eliminating the intercompany transaction. So these all settings you are required to do within the application for eliminating your intercompany numbers. So that's it from my side. In case of any question or support, please feel free to visit to our website www.bispsolutions.com. Thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you.